ilanja sibizelwe. Now, let me say something very controversial. The biggest controversy for me in scripture is the prayer of Moses for the children of Israel. Yomthandazo mina ngishupha ngeza abantu bayobabaza uMose wathandazela abantu baIsrael wenzani kodwa mina ngine problem nalowo mthandazo yimina mhlambe wena into uMose indoda iright ethandazela abantu abahluphayo but mina I've got a problem with the prayer of Moses because it cost him his destiny. And said we saw none of the people he prayed for entered the promised land anyway. Into ebhlungu yilapha. Uthi akukhona umuntu oyedwa uMose amthandazelile owangena ezweni lesethembiso. Not one. Not one. Not one othandazelwe uMose owangena. Abantu abangena yilaba uNkulunkulu abefungile ngaye. Uthi laba because they have a different spirit, these ones shall enter. What if from 20 years below, all of, from 20 years above, that generation I'm going to kill all of them in the wilderness. But Caleb and Joshua, because they have a different spirit, they shall enter. So umthandazo ka Mose, wa menza ukuthi angangeni. Abantu abathandazele kanti uNkulunkulu ehlakaniphele kwawo kodwa ngikhona abazalwane uNkulunkulu ehlakaniphele mbheke uNkulunkulu wenzani uthi no I need my people to function in three dimensions of office. Kumbula nono wamaye save kwa save amadodana amathathu namakhosikazi amathathu and that's very prophetic in relation to the descendants. Mangafunda ama descendants of all of them uyobona uyobona the prophetic implication of God saving Shem, Jem, and Japheth, Ham, and Shem. But angikhona angibayeki. Ngithathe uMose, ngithathe uCaleb, ngithathe uJoshua. Are you aware that when God wanted to save them, he wanted to preserve three offices that every Christian must operate in? Yes. Yes. He wanted to save Moses. Let's bargain. I want to kill all of them because they are stiff-necked. I will start something new with you, with Joshua, with Caleb. So, preserve Mose, when I know Caleb, no Joshua, you get this on the September. Labang so babula labong. What on God, no matter to name, Nemizian, your current age. Because if I have preserved Moses, I've preserved the priesthood, the priestly order. If I preserve, because he's from the house of Levi. And if I preserve Joshua, he's from the house of Ephraim, from where the first ordained Nabi, the first name, the first Nabi will come from Ephraim. So I preserve the prophetic, and the king shall come from Judah. So Caleb is from the house of Judah. So I will preserve Caleb because he's from the house of Judah. I will preserve Moses because he's from the house of Levi. And then I will preserve Joshua because he's from the house of Ephraim. Laba, Kiyokina, the priestly office, the prophetic office, and the kingly office. But it's not enough. There's a king who will come as a type of Christ. His name shall be David. And only him as a king will operate in the three offices. And that's why he had to be anointed three times. The first time in the house, that was a priestly anointing in the house. Let me tell you why. Because the ark had to come back. In fact, even before the ark came back, afune isinkwa sokubukwa esidliwa abapriesti kuphela. Now he can't break protocol and order. So before he goes and eats, I will allow a priestly anointing to come upon him. So that even when he eats, to people he'll be breaking protocol. But to me, he'll be authorized as a priest to eat from the bread. Secondly, I need a prophet. That is why, oh, you remember when the Ark of the Covenant came back? Why? bafabantu. What why? The Ark of the Covenant. I fagwa makos. I fagwa ba priest. Little people who David was changing path. What oga ilin and effort. The priestly garment. Young then. The Ark of the Covenant. Gobe se odin path e fanele gil. Oh shana. Uchehobu shagan pile. Oh God. What he? But I need him to be anointed the second time as a prophet in the house of Judah. That is why they called him. Only the people of Judah, the men of Judah, anointed him. That was the prophetic anointing. Until at Hebron, until the entire Israel, because he was not going to be a partial king. The promise about God was that David shall rule Israel. The entire nation, not only the house of Judah. There is a third anointing that's going to come upon you. And when it comes, it will not be Aban Basa Judah. It will be the entire Israel. So that you rise as a king. Because you are representing Jesus who is to come. Kwatata u Joseph. Watu wanaye uza operator kula ma dimensions sama tatu. Ngiyaphuthuma manje. UJosepha wathathwa wanikezwa a multicolored garment, which was his prophetic destiny. Because it was talking about what was to come. Mena hashaka. Nations through his wisdom will be saved. Through the wisdom of Joseph. He was given a multicolored intermens garment. Why sengenindli nika Potiphar? Why senigezwa igarment ehleli in prison? Equke ingubo zoyiboshwa. And when you look at the ministry he was performing a priestly ministry in prison. Because he was more an intercessor. He was a man that stands in the gap between people and divinity. When they have dreams that they can't even explain, he has to come as a priest. What why it's not enough? My pumechel, aga shave ashintim pas, because now he needs to rule as a governor. Little people wa shave, wa ashintim pas, wa kogisim pas. Ufarwati, uyo pata uzupate nomgam, only me. Ufarwati, imina ngeto, ongega pato uwe. But everything in Egypt and everyone in Egypt. Ilawulwa nguwe. Kwa kreatwa I opo. Lale laba salwa. Kwa kreatwa I poste ngeko. Just to accommodate the kingly anointing. The garment of governance upon Joseph. Zonke lezi nto, they are pointing us to someone. Zonke lezi. All of them. They are pointing us to Moses, Caleb, and Joshua, they are pointing us to someone. David's three anointings are pointing us to someone. Joseph's three changes of clothes are pointing us to someone. That is why the first cloak had to be dipped in blood for the redemption of his prophetic destiny. That's why the symbolism, the destiny of the boy has already been redeemed in the blood. He learned as good, not David, Mayolwa, Utavit, Eolwa, no Goliath. Little Papili, they went down to a valley called Ephas Damim. Ephas Damim is called the boundary of the blood, which means that by the time Utavit fit, Ubesen a home ground advantage, because only the blood speaks sense to us. Abantu Ikazi, Ikaz, Mazalikaz, Alishulu Tokbant, Quatakin Abakolwa. That is why when I see the blood, when I see the blood, I will pass over. Agashu, when I see order in your house, when I see abantwana bakho bayiphethe kahle, when I see ukuthi yonke into ihamba kahle emshadweni wakho, when I see Ismail, when I see the blood. kwenzeka abantu babe ne order in the house kodwa inkosi mayifike emakhatameni yezindlu zabo igazi lingatholakali kwenzeka abantwana bakho babe ne disorder kodwa umuthixo efika abona igazi likaJesu and then he will pass over because of the blood. Oh, now please be seated. I'm about to be done. So now uJesu uyazalwa kuthiwa uma esestebeleni uzobonwa kuphela abeluzi. Ngiyakubona ukuthi lamadoda lawa asuka from the east baye babadwebe bemile phansi kwesiphembu bemeduze kwesitebele nengane iqeda ukuzalwa. That's a distortion of biblical truth. Labantu azange bathola uJesu esitebeleni. Abantu abathola uJesu esitebeleni ama abelusi. Only the shepherds were there because the lamb was born. And the lamb will not be born in a hotel. Remember, abayanga hotel hayi ngoba imali bengekho. Bekuvaleka ispace ngoba iprophecy ithi out of Bethlehem shall come the savior. So the lamb had to be born in a stable, in a manger. Yini why in a manger? Ngoba in a manger kwakugcinwa khona amajuba. Kugcinwa izimbuzi. Kugcinwa amagusha anikelwayo njengemihlatshelo. Kwase kuthiwa angazalelwa ehotel, akazalelwe kulesi sitebele. To make an announcement ukuthi sengifikile, silibongile igazi lenu. But the lamb that taketh away the sin of the world has now arrived. Ngathi bethi sebenganihlaba nje mabefuna ukudla. But not because your blood means anything. Because now I have come to redeem them with the precious blood that comes direct from the throne room of God. Now, mbeke uJesu mabefika kuyena. Laba lithi iBhayibheli they came mabefika. It was 2 years already uJesu esezele. So that's why he was not in a stable. Because he did not stay. Read the scripture. That's why Herod ordered ukuthi bonke abantwana abana 2 years down must be killed. Because by this time 2 years have passed. So Jesu engahlalanga esitebeleni, uJesu besekhaya. La ebehlala khona, wengeke esitebeleni, bafika ekhaya. Ingakho lisho kanjani iBhayibheli lithi and the star stood upon the house where the child was, not the stable where the child was, the house where the child was. And futhi siye ke lento ukuthi bebathathu ngoba asitshelwanga. There's no number in the Bible of how many wise men were there. Sidithwa ama gifts ngoba dithwa types of gifts, gold, myrrh and incense. So sicaba ukuthi oyedwa ubephethe igolide oyedwa. No, asitshelwanga inamba. Asingayi. Yazi ukuthi siye sithi 3 wise men, but they are not 3. We don't know how many they were, but we know the types of gifts they presented. Mabe present ama gifts. But we present incense because this child is a priest. Umpristo shintsha oshisa impepho. Umpristo oshintsha oshisa impepho. Impepho ishiswa umpristo. So umpristo uyena oshisa impepho. Simlethele impepho. Ngoba umpristo lo. That is why. You see, if you read Numbers chapter 14 verse 6, if you go to Leviticus, uzothola ukuthi priests were not allowed to rent their clothes, because once you rent your clothes, it's a sign of end of term. Mawuke wasidabula impahla. Hence ngesikhathi abantwana bephikisana ngendaba yokungena, Joshua and Caleb, because they were not from the priesthood, they could tear their garments. But Moses and Aaron could not tear their garments because they are from the house of Levi. Now, Alessos card, Caiaphas is the outgoing priest, high priest. Ananias is the incoming high priest. kwakaka ukuthi umpriesto omkhulu akakwazi ukuyongena on the day on the sabbath on the day of Yom Kippur, the day of atonement. Umpriesto omkhulu onguKristu akakwazi ukuzithatha yena njengomhlatshelo ayongena endaweni engcwele ngcwele kusekhona ubupriesto obukhona.